the fear of being yourself. Focus on your business and career and the mask that you wear, the persona that you project out into the world. Focus on the energy that takes to keep up a mask, concerned about what your image is. Look at your website, social media, look at everything that you project out into the world. Look at the inaccuracies compared to yourself, projecting out that image and the total fear of being revealed of who you really are. We need to recognise this may be preventing sales, it's even maybe preventing huge businesses come buying into your product because you're not displaying what is in the window. Focus now on the image that you're portraying and the fear connected to your true spirituality deep within inside yourself. Because of what you've been through in this lifetime and previous lifetimes, you are absolutely scared and terrified of being revealed. Notice now those horrible feelings inside your stomach, your cerebellum, connected to saying what you really feel. And that society in general, perhaps not ready for you being you. You being exceptionally real. Follow that fake profile now into the past as you open up the Akashic Records, the Book of Life, back into the past, all the way back, deeper and deeper to your heart, to your solar plexus, where you're absolutely terrified of your spirituality, true self, your true essence, your true soul being revealed. Terrified. Drop into the lack of self-worth. Not good enough. Perhaps not even loving yourself. Terrified to show who you really are to the world. Fear. Rejection. Reprisal. Aggression, hatred, fear of being confronted, fear of actually saying what you once say, society stifling your voice in your throat, in your solar plexus, stifling you, containing you. Follow all that tension now into your stomach, into your intestine. Notice how your intestine is all recalled, it's compressed. Absolutely terrified of what people might think about you. If you were to say what you really felt, who you really are. Drop inside your cerebral plexus, your stomach, darkness, pain, may even be, as you open up the Akashic Records, Book of Life, an execution of yourself in a previous life for being yourself. Expressing your spiritual beliefs. Drop into a time where this was punishable by death. Now you don't need to go directly into that death. Keep yourself safe. Just fall backwards, wrapped in white light into that image. Drop beneath that image of whatever happened. The mob rule, outcast in a tribe, not being accepted, drop into that place of not accepting yourself, totally scared, speaking your mind, find that place in your spiritual beliefs, Because God sees you. God loves you. God's universe sees you. The universe loves you. Is it okay? Now, today, start loving yourself. Speaking the truth. See that truth. Feel that truth. Flying through your sacral plexus. Letting all the tension go. Know that in minutes, more than a lifetime, there is no execution, and you are safe for speaking your mind. And the worst that can happen, someone deletes you on social media, or doesn't buy your product, or you may have some public ridicule from people who are in a very, very dark place. Still have a lot to learn on this earth. Look at those people now, which are a minority, that are terrified of what you had to offer. Step away from that crowd and look back at them and ask yourself, why do you keep pandering to these people? You are not of these people, and they are not of you. They are not where you are, spiritually, physically, mentally, or physically. So the metabolic structure of your internal being is completely different. And until they embrace their own spirituality, they are lost. They are a lost tribe. It is not your convince them of their soul, their spiritual element, to cut all the cords connected to people in the past, present and future, and no longer find that place in your soul, the need to have to explain to these people. Cut all the academia cords, see yourself as a soul. Doing what's right for you, and your family, and your friends, and your business. Take your business back and express yourself complete wholeness, nothingness. Drop into your nothing in the stomach. Just cut those cords connected to right now. Now shut these lifetimes down, healing up everything inside of your stomach, your cervix, and float towards the here and now. Bring in all of your learnings, all the knowledge that you gathered these previous times, letting go of all of the condemnation, placing self-acceptance and self-love into every situation that reminds you of that. Whenever you feel challenged in the area of self-acceptance, self-reliance will take over, self-love will take over, self-confidence will take over. And use yourself, goodbye, say goodbye to those that don't know who they are. With love, say goodbye and allow them to heal and have their own journey. And by letting go of the rope of resistance, letting go of the tug of rope of resistance, these people will fall back and then they will experience their own journey because they have no one else to fight. Because you have let go of the rope. And when you're ready, fall into a deep sleep. Or come back into the here and now. And open your eyes. the fear of being yourself. Focus on your business and career and the mask that you wear, the persona that you project out into the world. Focus on the energy that that takes to keep up a mask, concerned about what your image is. Look at your website, social media, look at everything that you project out into the world. Look at the inaccuracies compared to yourself, projecting out that image and the total fear of being revealed of who you really are. We need to recognise this may be preventing sales, it's even maybe preventing huge businesses buying into your product because you're not displaying what is in the window. Focus now on the image that you're portraying and the fear connected to your true spirituality deep inside yourself. Because of what you've been through in this lifetime and previous lifetime, you are absolutely scared and terrified of being revealed. Notice now those horrible feelings inside your stomach, your cerebral plexus, connected to saying what you really feel, and that society in general perhaps not ready for you being you and you being exceptionally real. Follow that fake profile now into the past as you open up the Akashic Records, the Book of Life, back into the past, all the way back, deeper and deeper, to your heart, to your solar plexus, where you're absolutely terrified of your spirituality, your true self, your true essence, your true soul being revealed. Terrified. Drop into the lack of self-worth. Not good enough. Perhaps not even loving yourself. Terrified to show who you really are to the world. Fear of rejection, reprisal, aggression, hatred. Fear of being confronted. Fear of actually saying what you want to say. Society stifling your voice. In your throat, in your solar plexus, stifling you, containing you. Pull all that tension now into your stomach, into your intestine. Notice how your intestine is all recalled, it's compressed. Absolutely terrified of what people might think about you. If you were to say what you really felt, who you really are, drop inside your cerebral plexus, your stomach, darkness, pain, may even be, as you open up the Akashic Records, Book of Life. An execution of yourself in a previous life for being yourself and expressing your spiritual beliefs. Drop into a time where this was punishable by death. Now you don't need to go directly into that death. Keep yourself safe. Just fall backwards, wrapped in white light, into that image, drop beneath that image of whatever happened to you. The mob rule, outcast in the tribe, not being accepted, drop into that place of not accepting yourself, totally scared, speaking your mind. Find that place in your spiritual beliefs. does God see you? God loves you. God's universe sees you. Universe loves you. Is it okay? Now, today, start loving yourself. Speaking the truth. See that truth, feel that truth flowing through your soul. Letting all the tension go. And know that in this modern lifetime, there is no execution. And you are safe for speaking your mind. And the worst that can happen, someone deletes you on social media. Or doesn't buy your product. Or you may have some public ridicule from people who are in a very, very dark place and still have a lot to learn on this earth. Look at those people now, which are a minority, that are terrified of what you had to offer. Step away from that crowd and look back at them and ask yourself, why do you keep pandering to these people? You are not of these people. They are not of you. They are not where you are spiritually, physically, mentally, or physically. It's a metabolic structure of your internal being. It's completely different. And until they embrace their own spirituality, they are lost. They are a lost tribe. It's not your job to convince them of their soul, their spiritual development, to cut all the cords connected to people in the past, present and future, and no longer find that place in your soul, the need to have to explain to these people. All the academia cords, see yourself as a soul, doing what's right for you, and your family, and your friends, and your business. Take your business back and express yourself complete wholeness, nothingness. Drop into your nothing in the stomach. Cut those cords connected to this right now. Now shut these lifetimes down, healing up everything inside of your stomach, your cell blocks, and float towards the here and now, bringing all of your learnings, all the knowledge that you gathered in these previous times, letting go of all of the condemnation, placing self-acceptance and self-love into every situation that reminds you of that. Whenever you feel challenged in the area of self-acceptance, self-reliance, take over. Self-love will take over. Self-confidence will take over. And you should say goodbye. Say goodbye to those that don't know who they are. With love, say goodbye and allow them to heal and have their own journey. And by letting go of the rope of resistance, letting go of the tug of rope of resistance, these people will fall back. And then they will experience their own journey. Because they have no one else to fight. Because you have let go of the rope. And when you're ready, fall into a deep sleep. Or come back into the here and now. And open your eyes. the fear of being yourself. Focus on your business and career and the mask that you wear, the persona that you project out into the world. Focus on the energy that that takes to keep up a mask, concerned about what your image is. Look at your website, social media, look at everything that you project out into the world. Look at the inaccuracies compared to yourself, projecting out that image and the total fear of being revealed of who you really are. We need to recognise this may be preventing sales, this even may be preventing huge businesses buying into your product because you're not displaying what is in the window. Focus now on the image that you're portraying and the fear connected to your true spirituality deep within. Because of what you've been through in this lifetime and previous lifetimes, you are absolutely scared and terrified of being revealed. Notice now those horrible feelings inside your stomach, your solar plexus, connected to saying what you really feel. And that society in general, perhaps not ready for you being you. You being exceptionally real. Follow that fake profile now into the past as you open up the Akashic Records, the Book of Life, back into the past, all the way back, deeper and deeper to your heart, to your solar plexus. We're absolutely terrified of your spirituality, true self, your true essence, your true soul being revealed. Terrified. Drop into the lack of self-worth. Not good enough. Perhaps not even loving yourself. Terrified to show who you really are to the world. Fear. Rejection. Reprisal. Aggression, hatred, fear of being confronted, fear of actually saying what you want to say, society stifling your voice in your throat, your solar plexus, stifling you, containing you. Put all that tension now into your stomach, just into your intestine. Notice how your intestine is all recalled, it's compressed. Absolutely terrified of what people might think about you. If you were to say what you really felt, who you really are. Drop inside your solar plexus, your stomach, darkness, pain, may even be, as you open up the Akashic Records, Book of Life, an execution of yourself in a previous life for being yourself. Expressing your spiritual beliefs. Drop into a time where this was punishable by death. Now you don't need to go directly into that death. Keep yourself safe. Just fall backwards, wrapped in white light into that image. Drop beneath that image of whatever happened. The mob rule, outcast in the tribe, not being accepted, drop into that place of not accepting yourself, totally scared, speaking your mind, find that place in your spiritual beliefs, Does God see you? God loves you. God's universe sees you. Universe loves you. Is it okay? Now, today, start loving yourself. Speaking the truth. See that truth. Feel that truth. Flowing through your sail backs. Letting all the tension go. And know that in minutes, more than a lifetime, there is no execution. And you are safe for speaking your mind. And the worst that can happen, someone deletes you on social media. Or doesn't buy your product. Or you may have some public ridicule from people who are in a very, very dark place and still have a lot to learn on this earth. Look at those people now, which are a minority, that are terrified of what you had to offer. Step away from that crowd and look back at them. And ask yourself, why do you keep pandering to these people? You are not of these people. And they are not of you. They are not where you are, spiritually, physically, mentally, or physically. So the metabolic structure of your internal being is completely different. And until they embrace their own spirituality, they are lost. They are a lost tribe. It is not your job to convince them, but their soul, their spiritual element, to cut all the cords connected to people in the past, present and future, and no longer find that place in your soul, the need to have to explain to these people. Cut all the academia cords. See yourself as a soul. Doing what's right for you, in your family, in your friends, in your business. Take your business back and express yourself complete wholeness. Nothingness. Into your nothing in the stomach. Just cut those cords connected to this right now. Now shut these lifetimes down, healing up everything inside of your stomach, your cell. And flow towards the here and now, bringing all of your learnings, all the knowledge that you gathered in these previous times, letting go of all of the condemnation, placing self-acceptance and self-love into every situation that reminds you of that, whenever you feel challenged. Self-acceptance, self-reliance will take over. Self-love will take over. Self-confidence will take over. And you should say goodbye to those that don't know who they are. With love, say goodbye and allow them to heal and have their own journey. And by letting go of the rope of resistance, letting go of the tug of rope, fall back, and then they will experience their own journey, because they have no one else to fight, because you have let go of the rope. When you're ready, fall into a deep sleep, or come back into the here and now, and open your eyes. the fear of being yourself. Focus on your business and career and the mask that you wear, the persona that you project out into the world. Focus on the energy that takes to keep up a mask, concerned about what your image is. Look at your website, social media, look at everything that you project out into the world. Look at the inaccuracies compared to yourself, projecting out that image and the total fear of being revealed of who you really are. We need to recognise this may be preventing sales, it's even maybe preventing huge businesses buying into your product because you're not displaying what is in the window. Focus now on the image that you're portraying and the fear connected to your true spirituality deep within inside yourself. Because of what you've been through in this lifetime and previous lifetimes, you are absolutely scared and terrified of being revealed. Notice now those horrible feelings inside your stomach, your solar, connected to saying what you really feel. That society in general, perhaps not ready for you being you. You being exceptionally real. Follow that fake profile now into the past as you open up the Akashic Records, the Book of Life, back into the past, all the way back, deeper and deeper to your heart, to your solar plexus, where you're absolutely terrified of your spirituality, true self, your true essence, your true soul being revealed. Terrified. Drop into the lack of self-worth. Not good enough. Perhaps not even loving yourself. Terrified to show who you really are to the world. Fear. Rejection. Reprisal. Aggression, hatred, fear of being confronted, fear of actually saying what you once say, society stifling your voice in your throat, in your solar plexus, stifling you, containing you. All that tension now into your stomach, just into your intestine. Notice how your intestine is all recalled, it's compressed. Absolutely terrified of what people might think about you. If you were to say what you really felt, who you really are. Drop inside your solar plexus, your stomach, darkness, pain, may even be, as you open up the Akashic Records, Book of Life, an execution of yourself in a previous life for being yourself. Expressing your spiritual beliefs. Drop into a time where this was punishable by death. Now you don't need to go directly into that death. Keep yourself safe. Just fall backwards, wrapped in white light into that image. Drop beneath that image of whatever happened. The mob rule, outcast in a tribe, not being accepted, drop into that place of not accepting yourself, totally scared, speaking your mind, find that place in your spiritual beliefs, Does God see you? God loves you. God's universe sees you. Universe loves you. Is it okay? Now, today, start loving yourself. Speaking the truth. See that truth. Feel that truth. Flying through your sacral plexus. Letting all the tension go. Know that in minutes, more than a lifetime, there is no execution, and you are safe for speaking your mind. And the worst that can happen, someone deletes you on social media, or doesn't buy your product, or you may have some public ridicule from people who are in a very, very dark place. Still have a lot to learn on this earth. Look at those people now, which are a minority, that are terrified of what you had to offer. Step away from that crowd and look back at them and ask yourself, why do you keep pandering to these people? You are not of these people, and they are not of you. They are not where you are, spiritually, physically, mentally, or physically. So the metabolic structure of your internal being is completely different. And until they embrace their own spirituality, they are lost. They are a lost tribe. It is not your convince them of their soul, their spiritual element, to cut all the cords connected to people in the past, present and future, and no longer find that place in your soul, the need to have to explain to these people. Cut all the academia cords, see yourself as a soul. Doing what's right for you, and your family, and your friends, and your business. Take your business back and express yourself complete wholeness, nothingness. Drop into your nothing in the stomach. Just cut those cords connected to right now. Now shut these lifetimes down, healing up everything inside of your stomach, your cerebellum, and float towards the here and now. Bring in all of your learnings, all the knowledge that you gathered these previous times, letting go of all of the condemnation, placing self-acceptance and self-love into every situation that reminds you of that. Whenever you feel challenged in the area of self-acceptance, self-reliance will take over, self-love will take over, self-confidence will take over. And use yourself, goodbye, say goodbye to those that don't know who they are. With love, say goodbye and allow them to heal and have their own journey. And by letting go of the rope of resistance, letting go of the tug of rope of resistance, these people will fall back and then they will experience their own journey because they have no one else to fight. Because you have let go of the rope. And when you're ready, fall into a deep sleep. Or come back into the here and now. And open your eyes. the fear of being yourself. Focus on your business and career and the mask that you wear, the persona that you project out into the world. Focus on the energy that that takes to keep up a mask, concerned about what your image is. Look at your website, social media, look at everything that you project out into the world. Look at the inaccuracies compared to yourself, projecting out that image and the total fear of being revealed of who you really are. We need to recognise this may be preventing sales, it's even maybe preventing huge businesses buying into your product because you're not displaying what is in the window. Focus now on the image that you're portraying and the fear connected to your true spirituality deep inside yourself. Because of what you've been through in this lifetime and previous lifetime, you are absolutely scared and terrified of being revealed. Notice now those horrible feelings inside your stomach, your cerebral plexus, connected to saying what you really feel, and that society in general perhaps not ready for you being you and you being exceptionally real. Follow that fake profile now into the past as you open up the Akashic Records, the Book of Life, back into the past, all the way back, deeper and deeper, to your heart, to your solar plexus, where you're absolutely terrified of your spirituality, your true self, your true essence, your true soul being revealed. Terrified. Drop into the lack of self-worth. Not good enough. Perhaps not even loving yourself. Terrified to show who you really are to the world. Fear of rejection, reprisal, aggression, hatred. Fear of being confronted. Fear of actually saying what you want to say. Society stifling your voice. In your throat, in your solar plexus, stifling you, containing you. Pull all that tension now into your stomach, just into your intestine. Notice how your intestine is all recalled, it's compressed. Absolutely terrified of what people might think about you. If you were to say what you really felt, who you really are, drop inside your cerebral plexus, your stomach, darkness, pain, may even be, as you open up the Akashic Records, Book of Life. An execution of yourself in a previous life for being yourself and expressing your spiritual beliefs. Drop into a time where this was punishable by death. Now you don't need to go directly into that death. Keep yourself safe. Just fall backwards, wrapped in white light, into that image, drop beneath that image of whatever happened to you. The mob rule, outcast in the tribe, not being accepted, drop into that place of not accepting yourself, totally scared, speaking your mind. Find that place in your spiritual beliefs. does God see you? God loves you. God's universe sees you. Universe loves you. Is it okay? Now, today, stop loving yourself. Speaking the truth. See that truth, feel that truth flowing through your soul. Letting all the tension go. And know that in this modern lifetime, there is no execution, and you are safe for speaking your mind. And the worst that can happen, someone deletes you on social media, or doesn't buy your product, or you may have some public ridicule from people who are in a very, very dark place and still have a lot to learn on this earth. Look at those people now, which are a minority, that are terrified of what you had to offer. Step away from that crowd and look back at them and ask yourself, why do you keep pandering to these people? You are not of these people. They are not of you. They are not where you are spiritually, physically, mentally, or physically. It's a metabolic structure of your internal being. It's completely different. And until they embrace their own spirituality, they are lost. They are a lost tribe. It's not your job to convince them of their soul, their spiritual development, to cut all the cords connected to people in the past, present and future, and no longer find that place in your soul, the need to have to explain to these people. All the academia cords, see yourself as a soul, doing what's right for you, and your family, and your friends, and your business. Take your business back and express yourself complete wholeness, nothingness. Drop into your nothing in the stomach. Cut those cords connected to this right now. Now shut these lifetimes down, healing up everything inside of your stomach, your cell blocks, and float towards the here and now, bringing all of your learnings, all the knowledge that you gathered in these previous times, letting go of all of the condemnation, placing self-acceptance and self-love into every situation that reminds you of that. Whenever you feel challenged in the area of self-acceptance, self-reliance, take over. Self-love will take over. Self-confidence will take over. And you should say goodbye. Say goodbye to those that don't know who they are. With love, say goodbye and allow them to heal and have their own journey. And by letting go of the rope of resistance, letting go of the tug of rope of resistance, these people will fall back. And then they will experience their own journey, because they have no one else to fight, because you have let go of the rope. When you're ready, fall into a deep sleep or come back into the here and now and open your eyes. of fear of being yourself. Focus on your business and career and the mask that you wear, the persona that you project out into the world. Focus on the energy that that takes to keep up a mask, concerned about what your image is. Look at your website, social media, look at everything that you project out into the world. Look at the inaccuracies compared to yourself, projecting out that image and the total fear of being revealed of who you really are. We need to recognise this may be preventing sales, it's even maybe preventing huge businesses buying into your product because you're not displaying what is in the window. Focus now on the image that you're portraying and the fear connected to your true spirituality deeper inside yourself. Because of what you've been through in this lifetime and previous lifetime, you are absolutely scared and terrified of being revealed. Notice now those horrible feelings inside your stomach, your cerebral plexus, connected to saying what you really feel, and that society in general perhaps not ready for you being you and you being exceptionally real. Follow that fake profile now into the past as you open up the Akashic Records, the Book of Life, back into the past, all the way back, deeper and deeper, to your heart, to your solar plexus, where you're absolutely terrified of your spirituality, your true self, your true essence, your true soul being revealed. Terrified. Drop into the lack of self-worth. Not good enough. Perhaps not even loving yourself. Terrified to show who you really are to the world. Fear of rejection, reprisal, aggression, hatred. Fear of being confronted. Fear of actually saying what you want to say. Society stifling your voice. In your throat, in your solar plexus, stifling you, containing you. Pull all that tension now into your stomach, into your intestine. Notice how your intestine is all recalled, it's compressed. Absolutely terrified of what people might think about you. If you were to say what you really felt, who you really are, drop inside your cerebral plexus, your stomach, darkness, pain, may even be, as you open up the Akashic Records, Book of Life. Execution of yourself in a previous life for being yourself and expressing your spiritual beliefs. Drop into a time where this was punishable by death. Now you don't need to go directly into that death. Keep yourself safe. Just fall backwards, wrapped in white light, into that image. Drop beneath that image of whatever happened to you. The mob rule. Outcast in the tribe. Not being accepted. Drop into that place of not accepting yourself. Totally scared. Speak in your mind. Find that place in your spiritual beliefs. Does God see you? God loves you. God's universe sees you. Universe loves you. Is it okay? Now, today, start loving yourself. Speaking the truth. See that truth, feel that truth flowing through your soul. Letting all the tension go. And know that in this modern lifetime, there is no execution. And you are safe for speaking your mind. And the worst that can happen, someone deletes you on social media. Or doesn't buy your product. Or you may have some public ridicule from people who are in a very, very dark place and still have a lot to learn on this earth. Look at those people now, which are a minority, that are terrified of what you had to offer. Step away from that crowd and look back at them and ask yourself, why do you keep pandering to these people? You are not of these people. They are not of you. They are not where you are spiritually, mentally, or physically. It's a metabolic structure of your internal being. It's completely different. And until they embrace their own spirituality, they are lost. They are a lost tribe. It's not your job to convince them of their soul, their spiritual development, to cut all the cords connected to people in the past, present and future, and no longer find that place in your soul, the need to have to explain to these people. All the academia cords, see yourself as a soul, doing what's right for you, and your family, and your friends, and your business. Take your business back and express yourself complete wholeness, nothingness. Drop into your nothing in the stomach. Cut those cords connected to this right now. Now shut these lifetimes down, healing up everything inside of your stomach, your cell blocks, and float towards the here and now, bringing all of your learnings, all the knowledge that you gathered in these previous times, letting go of all of the condemnation, placing self-acceptance and self-love into every situation that reminds you of that. Whenever you feel challenged in the area of self-acceptance, self-reliance, take over. Self-love will take over. Self-confidence will take over. And you should say goodbye. Say goodbye to those that don't know who they are. With love, say goodbye and allow them to heal and have their own journey. And by letting go of the rope of resistance, letting go of the tug of rope of resistance, these people will fall back. And then they will experience their own journey. Because they have no one else to fight. Because you have let go of the rope. And when you're ready, fall into a deep sleep. Or come back into the here and now. And open your eyes. the fear of being yourself. Focus on your business and career and the mask that you wear, the persona that you project out into the world. Focus on the energy that that takes to keep up a mask, concerned about what your image is. Look at your website, social media, look at everything that you project out into the world. Look at the inaccuracies compared to yourself, projecting out that image and the total fear of being revealed of who you really are. We need to recognise this may be preventing sales, this even may be preventing huge businesses buying into your product because you're not displaying what is in the window. Focus now on the image that you're portraying and the fear connected to your true spirituality deep inside yourself. Because of what you've been through in this lifetime and previous lifetime, you are absolutely scared and terrified of being revealed. Notice now those horrible feelings inside your stomach, your solar connected to saying what you really feel, and that society in general perhaps not ready for you being you and you being exceptionally real. Follow that fake profile now into the past as you open up the Akashic Records, the Book of Life, back into the past, all the way back, deeper and deeper, to your heart, to your solar plexus. We're absolutely terrified of your spirituality, your true self, your true essence, your true soul being revealed. Terrified. Drop into the lack of self-worth. Not good enough. Perhaps not even loving yourself. Terrified to show who you really are to the world. Fear of rejection, reprisal, aggression, hatred. Fear of being confronted. Fear of actually saying what you want to say. Society stifling your voice. In your throat, your solar plexus, stifling you, containing you. Follow all that tension now into your stomach, just into your intestine. Notice how your intestine is all recalled, it's compressed, absolutely terrified of what people might think about you. You were to say what you really felt, who you really are. Drop inside your solar plexus, your stomach, darkness, pain, maybe as you open up the Akashic Records, Book of Life. An execution of yourself in a previous life for being yourself and expressing your spiritual beliefs. Drop into a time where this was punishable by death. Now you don't need to go directly into that death. Keep yourself safe. Just fall backwards. Wrapped in white light into that image, drop beneath that image of whatever happened to you. The mob rule, outcast in the tribe, not being accepted, drop into that place of not accepting yourself, totally scared, speaking your mind, find that place in your spiritual beliefs. Does God see you? God loves you. God's universe sees you. The universe loves you. Is it okay? Now, today, start loving yourself. Speaking the truth. See that truth. Feel that truth. Flowing through your sail plugs. Letting all the tension go. Know that in minutes, modern lifetime, there is no execution, and you are safe for speaking your mind. And the worst that can happen, someone deletes you on social media, or doesn't buy your product, or you may have some public ridicule from people who are in a very, very dark place. Still have a lot to learn on this earth. Look at those people now, which are a minority, that are terrified of what you had to offer. Step away from that crowd and look back at them and ask yourself, why do you keep pandering to these people? You are not of these people, and they are not of you. They are not where you are, spiritually, physically, mentally, or physically. It's a metabolic structure of your internal being. It's completely different. And until they embrace their own spirituality, they are lost. They are a lost tribe. And it's not your convince them of their soul, their spiritual development, to cut all the cords connected to people in the past, present and future, and no longer find that place in your soul, the need to have to explain to these people. Cut all the academia cords, see yourself as a soul. Doing what's right for you, and your family, and your friends, and your business. Take your business back and express yourself complete wholeness, nothingness. Drop into your nothing in the stomach. Just cut those cords connected to right now. Now shut these lifetimes down, healing up everything inside of your stomach, your cervix, and float towards the here and now. Bring in all of your learnings, all the knowledge that you gathered in these previous times, letting go of all of the condemnation, placing self-acceptance and self-love into every situation that reminds you of that. Whenever you feel challenged in the area of self-acceptance, self-reliance will take over, self-love will take over, self-confidence will take over. And you should say goodbye, say goodbye to those that don't know who they are. With love, say goodbye and allow them to heal and have their own journey. And by letting go of the rope of resistance, letting go of the tug of rope of resistance, these people will fall back and then they will experience their own journey because they have no one else to fight. Because you have let go of the rope.